Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to machine learning tutorial, and today we'll be going to discuss our first basic classification algorithm, that is Naïve Bayes. So guys, before jumping into Naïve Bayes algorithm, first let's try to understand the basic intuition of Bayes theorem, and we'll see how we can make use of Bayes theorem for solving classification problems. So guys, let's take an example where we'll understand conditional probability categorized as dependent and independent event. So when I say independent event, then it means each event is not affected by any other events. Let's say if I toss two coins and each toss of a coin is perfect isolated thing, and what it did in the past will not affect the current toss, so the chances of getting a head or tail will always be 50%. And we can say that each toss is an independent event. But what if current event is affected by previous event? Then that will be categorized as dependent event. So let's understand this with one real world scenario. Now suppose we have two events, event A and event B, where event A is drawing a king first from the deck of cards, and event B is drawing a king second. For the first card, the chance of drawing a king would be 4 out of 52, as there are 4 kings in a deck of 52 cards. So guys, probability of event A will be 4 over 52. After picking up a card, now we have 51 cards in total, and we'll draw second king card from the deck, so our probability of event B will be 3 over 51, as only 3 kings are left after the first card pickup. So guys, if you can notice, here event B is depending on event A, means probability will keep changing when we move for further events, as here we are trying to find probabilities from the remaining cards. Now suppose if I want to find probability for both the occurrence of event A and event B, that is nothing but the P of A and B will be 4 over 52 over 3 over 51, that is 1 over 2 to 1. So guys, for finding dependencies of the event, we can calculate conditional probability. So let's understand this. So we have a formula for conditional probability, that is probability of B given A, means for finding probability of event B, we already know the probability of event A, what we have seen earlier. So probability of B given A will be probability of A and B over probability of A. So guys, let's see whether we are getting correct outcome or not for above mentioned example of deck after applying this formula. So according to the formula, we have to find out the probability of B given A is equal to probability of A and B over probability of A. So I'll simply put the value of probability of A and B, what we find just now, that is 1 over 2 to 1, and probability of A, that is 4 over 52. So here we are getting probability of B given A as 3 over 51. Now let's see how we can derive Bayes theorem using conditional probability. Now we have an equation of probability of B given A equal to probability of A and B over probability of A, where we have to find conditional probability of B with probability of A already given. And we have another equation, that is probability of A given B equal to probability of B and A over probability of B, where we have to find conditional probability of A with probability of B already given. So guys, just to add one thing, that probability of A and B is the probability of both A and B occurring, which is the same as probability of A occurring times the probability that B occurs given that A occurred. Using the same reasoning, probability of A and B is also the probability that B occurs times the probability that A occurs given that B occurs. The fact that these two expressions are equal leads to Bayes theorem. So guys, this relates the probability of hypothesis before getting the evidence to the probability of hypothesis after getting the evidence. For this reason, probability of A is called the prior probability, while probability of A given B is called the posterior probability. The factor that relates the two probability of B given A over probability of B is called the likelihood ratio. Using these terms, Bayes theorems can be rephrased as the posterior probability equals the prior probability times the likelihood ratio. So guys, as we have clear understanding of dependent and independent events, conditional probability and Bayes theorem, let's quickly see how we can use these informations for building our naive Bayes classifier. So naive Bayes classifier are simple probabilistic classifiers that uses Bayes theorem, and it has strong independence assumptions between features. In simple term, I can say that a naive Bayes classifier assumes that the presence of a particular feature in a class is not related to the presence of any other feature. Let's say a ball may be considered as a soccer ball if it is hard, round, and about 7 inches in diameter. Even if these features depend on each other, naive Bayes believes that all of these properties independently contribute to the probability that this ball is a soccer ball, and that is why it is known as naive. So guys, now we have a formula for Bayes theorem that we have just derived, that is P of A given B equal to P of B given A into P of A over P of B. Now let's see how we can apply this to classification problem. Let's say I have dependent variable Y and different features or independent variables, that is x1, x2, x3 and so on, for solving the classification problem. So here we have to predict the y value based on the x components, and this y value would be discrete value. So guys, if you can see the Bayes theorem, we have to find out the P of A given B, and we can transform this as probability of y given x. Means we already have x values for finding the outcome, and that is nothing but the y value. But here we have more than one independent variable, so we can write it as probability of y given x1, x2, x3 up to xn. Now we'll compute the probability of B given A as shown in the equation, and that will be probability of x1 given y into probability of x2 given y into probability of x3 given y up to probability of xn given y. Now we have to multiply this term with probability of A according to the equation, and here A is nothing but y. So we'll multiply this by probability of y, and we'll divide this by probability of B, and that is nothing but all x components. So I can write it as probability of x1 into probability of x2 into probability of x3 up to probability of xn. So guys, now we have transformed Bayes theorem according to our use case. Now let's simplify this equation by writing it as probability of y pi from 1 to n probability of xi given y over probability of x1 into probability of x2 into probability of x3 up to probability of xn. Just to add one thing, that we'll not consider denominator for as of now, as this is just a constant, and this will be same for each iterations. So guys, if you can see, our numerator will be directly proportional to probability of y given x. And since classification involves assigning the class to the data point, we will take the argmax of probability of y pi from 1 to n probability of xi given y. Argmax is nothing but the selecting highest value. Suppose this equation is giving class A as probability of 0.1 and class B as probability of 0.9. So we will consider class B as our output according to the argmax function. Now let's quickly see how we can implement all of these with real world data set. So guys, we have a data set as shown on the screen, where we have a color of car, type of car and origin of car is categorized as independent variable, and we have to find the dependent variable, that is based on these conditions whether this car has been stolen or not, simply yes or no condition. So by looking into the training data, we can predict for the test data, and let's say I want to predict the outcome for red domestic SUV car which is not present in the training data
if you can see on the screen.
Okay, so now based on this, we can create separate table for these rows as shown on the screen. Now we have three tables for each x component. And let me explain you how we have created this table. So we have simply listed how many yes and no are there for color red. And same we have done for yellow color as well. So in total, we have 5 yes and 5 no. So by using this, we can find the probability of yes and no as well. And same we will do for creating type and origin table. Now we have to find out that car is stolen or not based on condition that car should be red, domestic and SUV. So let's quickly look into probability of red given yes, probability of SUV given yes and probability of domestic given yes. Now, according to Bayes theorem, we can substitute these values in the equation shown on the screen. And that is probability of yes given car equal to probability of red given yes into probability of SUV given yes into probability of domestic given yes over probability of car. So guys, here with respect to each term, probability of car will be same. So I can skip this as a moment. And now I will get probability of yes given car as 0.048. Now let's quickly calculate for probability of no given car. So here we can substitute probability of red given no into probability of SUV given no into probability of domestic given no, what we have already found during the table creation. And we have probability of no given car as 0.144. Now last step is to determine whether car is stolen or not. So how we'll do that? We will simply normalize the P of yes given car to 1 by taking 0.048 in numerator and dividing it with the addition of both probability of yes given car and probability of no given car values, that is 0.048 divided by 0.048 plus 0.144. And guys, after this calculation, probability of yes given car is coming as 0.25 and probability of no given car will be 0.25. So guys, here we will select the larger value as our output. So we can conclude that car has not been stolen as it classifies as no. So guys, I have mentioned some of the advantages and disadvantages of naive Bayes classifier as this performs best on smaller datasets, then it can be used for both binary or multi-class classification problem. But it assumes that all the attributes are mutually independent. In real life, it's almost impossible that we get a set of predictors that are completely independent to one another. And guys, one of the major drawback is if a categorical variable has a category in the test dataset which was not observed in training dataset, then the model will assign a zero probability and will be unable to make a prediction. This is often known as zero frequency. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.